हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू bispTrainings.com। माय नेम इज अमित शर्मा एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू हाउ टू कैलकुलेट ओपनिंग बैलेंस इन हाईपीएम फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट। वी वुड लर्न दिस कैलकुलेशन इन टू स्टेप। इन फर्स्ट एग्जांपल आई शो यू ओपनिंग बैलेंस कैलकुलेशन यूजिंग सिंपल नोट पैड टेक्स्ट एडिटर एंड द सेम एग्जाम्पल वी वुड बी यूजिंग यूजिंग कैलकुलेशन मैनेजर। So this way you will be able to compare, and idea over here is to make you familiar with the calculation manager interface. So let's get started. So this is a simple script which we are going to discuss today. I will split into multiple pieces and understand how it works. So as we discussed in the previous session, fundamental of HFM rules, calculate is a pre-built procedure and HFM follow VB script, and therefore sub calculate and end sub is a starting and ending point of your procedure, and calculate is a pre-built procedure which gets calculated when you right click on your data grid or data form. This procedure gets calculated. Okay, so for example, I show you over here. Assume this is my data grid. When I right click and calculate, force calculate or calculate, the calculate procedure gets called, right? The next step, we declare variable. If you look at this, in order to declare variable, we can write dim to declare variable, but it is not mandatory in HFM because it follow VB script. Therefore, we have a forward declaration. You can directly write a name of variable and the value of the variable. HS is the topmost object in HFM object hierarchy. Value is the name of value dimension, and dot member. What does it mean? The current point of view of value dimension will be assigned to my variable value. Current point of view of value dimension in data grid or data form. So in this data grid or web grid, the current point of view of my value dimension is entity currency. See? Entity currency will assign to my value variable. Next line, we have a nested if condition. Next line checks HS topmost entity dot is base function, okay, which takes two argument. So any function start with IS, it return true or false. It's a boolean. It return either true or false. It takes two argument double quotes. You see, the first argument is called parent. So you can pass any entity dimension member parent. And second argument is your child, right? So it means you can pass for any parent and any child, the calculation will take place. If you leave them empty, it means for all the parents, all the children, the calculation will take place. So this if condition gets satisfied or gets it make it true for all the level 0 member or bottommost member of my entity dimension. You can see over here in data grid, this is my entity dimension. I have chosen over here corp operation, and which is my level 0 member, bottommost member of my my entity dimension. So condition is true. So in this case, in this data grid, the outer condition, if value dimension is entity currency, and inner condition, if entity dimension member is bottommost member, both conditions are true. If both conditions true, we'll calculate opening balance. Right? In order to calculate opening balance, let me erase this first. I highlight it. We use hs.expression to calculate something. Whatever appear before the equal operator is your target, and whatever appear after equal operator is the source. So what is my source? The closing C1 is your custom dimension 1, which is flow in our example. And in order to refer any member of custom dimension, any dimension, you write dimension abbreviation, which is C1 hash name of member. So the closing balance of previous year, prior is previous year, Y for year, for last month for previous year, last month, this is period, will assign to opening balance. In simple word, 2014 December 2014 December, closing balance would be opening for 2015 January. This is a simple mean. And then I close a if condition over here using AND IF. This condition, if condition, gets closed over here, and the sub procedure gets closed over here. So this is what your procedure look like. Let's do this live. I'm going to write this procedure into my notepad, then load it, and then we test it. Okay. So just open your login to your workspace. Open a notepad editor. I'm going to open notepad, any text editor, and I'm going to write this manually. The only problem with this approach, there's no way to validate it. You need a good amount of practice to write the programming. Sub, calculate, and sub. Write a first you declare a variable. Name of my variable is value, hs.value.member. So whatever point of view select, assign to my value variable. Okay. Then write a fifth if condition. If value equals to double quotes, I write entity currency. Then write nested if condition. I close this if condition over here. You immediately close it so that you ensure that all if conditions are balanced, in order to avoid any confusion at later point of time. Another if condition: if hs.entity.member hs.entity is base for all the parent and all children, I leave it empty. Then write second if condition, close it, and if, and I write an expression over here, hs.expression and double quotes, custom one dimension opening, custom one hash opening equals to custom one closing. You see it's the name of opening dimension member of flow, custom one dimension member, flow member called opening and closing. The name of custom one dimension is flow. Closing, for I use dot operator differentiate to distinguish one dimension on another dimension. For last period, previous year, so I write prior for previous year, last for last period. Okay. The only problem with this approach, there is no way to validate this, so you need to manually validate. I already have one rule. We can validate against this rule. Opening, closing, last and prior. Perfect. It seems to be correct. We'll test it and we get to know if any error come. So I call this calc opening balance dot RLE. Calculate opening balance dot RLE is an extension for rule. Save this and I'm going to load this. So in order to load this, you go to consolidate, load section, application elements, browse to your rules, browse, go to rule. I sort by timestamp to ensure we are the correct 627 timestamp. You can scan it before you load it so you get to know any syntactical error. Scan, look at the log file, no error, no warning, perfect. So at least it doesn't have any syntactical error. Now let's check the, let's load this and test it. Load is done and now we can test it. Okay, look at the log file finally, no error, no warning, perfect. So I already have a data form, data grid created, which consists of your custom one dimension member, flow members on your column, and period in your rows, right? So whatever I write in opening balance, in closing, for last period, for 2008, closing value is 2222. This closing value become 2009 opening. So I change my year 2009. Opening, right? Simple right click and invoke calculate. If everything is correct, you can see over here 2222. You see 2222. So 2008 closing period become 2009 opening period. I put value for 2000 last period over here, right? So this is one way of doing it. If you find this approach a little difficult, you can do it. There's one more alternate way using calculation manager. It's a GUI based and therefore it's a good easy for beginners. So before you start calculation manager, make sure the service is up and running. You can see under console, WebLogic console, my calculation manager service is up and running with 8500 port. Then you can go to administration and start your calculation manager. Right. So this is your calculation manager. Default view is called system view. And there you can see HFM, planning and space. You can expand HFM because I want this to run under calculate function. I can right click and create new rule. Create new rule. It's pretty simple. Just give a name of your rule. I give a name called calculate opening balance, OB. The type of application is HFM, which is consolidation. I have only one HFM application called BISP HFM, and calculation type is calculate. Okay. This is GUI interface. We can keep our calculation in front of us and test it. So this is what I need to write. So first, we need a conditional statement. Under rule palette, you can see condition, drag and drop, and place condition over here. What is the condition? We like to check the condition tab. I like to check this condition. A value dimension member equals to entity currency. The condition, on the right side, you see condition option. Add condition, click on this. Under function, select function, value dimension, member. Again, scroll down and select value dimension, member. Value dimension, member. Value dimension, member equals to, value equals to entity currency, which is member. So, select your member. Our dimension is entity currency, and you can add this. Click on add, the condition got created. Okay, save it, and step by step we do it. There are two mode called designer mode, which is graphical, and there's another mode called edit script. Click on edit script mode, and there you can see whatever I am doing it behind the screen, a condition is being rendered. Your calculation manager is rendering the script, which is making your job easy. So first if condition is ready. Now I need another if condition under this for entity dimension base members. I switch back to designer view. If you want, you can directly type over here up to your comfort. I'll drag and drop, put another if condition under main if condition. So it's a nesting. This is my second if condition. The condition over here, I can select if entity dimension is base member. So select function, entity is base, is base member, takes two argument, parent entity and child entity. That's the beauty of it. You don't need to memorize the syntax. Equals to, I add over here, basically I don't need equals to. So I can save and look at the edit script. Save, look at edit script, and basically we don't need this equals to. I can remove it over here. Save it, and my session got expired anyway. Now after two condition we have got calculation. Right, after two condition there is a calculation of opening balance. So I switch to my designer view once again. in order to perform calculation, I use formula, drag and drop and place formula over here. And there give a formula name, caption, description, comments. Okay, you can click on formula section. The left side of equal to operator is your target. Select on this, select member, member, member is custom dimension flow, my opening balance, which is under my all customer total flow, opening, equals to closing balance. I can type it over here, is up to your comfort. Select member, closing from flow dimension, select closing. For, I can type it over here directly, for last period prior year, last period prior year, that's it. So you can save this and look at the final view, edit window, edit view. So you see the script is similar to the one which we prepared, but you got additional if condition. You can eliminate if you don't need this, you eliminate this if condition. If you need it, you can keep it. I don't need any condition as of now, so I can click and delete this. I save this. This is done. Script mode, it is going to be saved. And it's already exists. I got some session related issue, but I save it and validate. We check the syntactical error first to ensure we don't have any error. And validate, validation pass with no error. We don't have any syntactical error. Alternatively, you can load validate from here, action, and validate your consolidation script. So that's it. You see there are two ways of writing calculation. You can use calculation manager under designer view and edit script, or you can manually type it as well, whichever way you feel comfortable. So this was a basic example. Next example, we see how to use variable. In next example, I am going to show you how to run calculate minority interest and currency translation. So that's it for today. Should you have any question, please feel free to write to us, www.bispsolutions.com. Thank you and have a great day ahead.